Hey guys, welcome to Initiate Scientia, where science meets you. In today's video, let's see about the lesson Current Electricity, ICSE Class 10 syllabus.
Today, let us learn about current electricity. Here, you are going to learn about the concept of charge, current, potential, potential difference, and resistance, Ohm's law, etc. Now, concept of charge. In class 9, you have read that when two non-conducting bodies such as glass and silk or ebonite and fur are rubbed together, there is a transfer of electrons from one body to the other. The body which gains electrons becomes negatively charged and the body which loses electrons becomes positively charged. So, therefore, there are two kinds of charges. One is positive charge and the other one is negative charge. Two like charges repel each other while two unlike charges attract each other. The charge on a body is denoted by the symbol Q, small q or capital Q. So, what is the unit of charge? The SI unit of charge is coulomb. Symbol is C. The smaller units of charge are millicoulomb, MC, microcoulomb, μC, and nanocoulomb, NC, where 1 mmC is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 coulomb. 1 μCoulomb is equal to 10 to the power of minus 6 coulomb, and 1 nanocoulomb, NC, is equal to 10 to the power of minus 9 C. Now, the quantity of charge on a body is determined by the number of electrons in deficit. If the body is positively charged, or the number of electrons in excess if the body is negatively charged. Thus, the charge on a body, that is Q, is equal to plus or minus Ne, where N is the number of electrons in deficit for positive sign and in excess for negative sign, while E is the charge on an electron. The charge on an electron is minus 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. So, 1 coulomb charge means a deficit of 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18. That is equal to 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 electrons. You should also note that in a non-conductor or insulator, the charges reside at a point where there is an excess or deficit of electrons. That is, the charge is static. It does not flow. On the other hand, in a conductor such as a metal, charges can move or flow. A conductor has a large number of free electrons in it, which can flow throughout the volume of the conductor. Now, let us see what is the concept of current. The charge in motion constitutes the electric current. Current is defined as a rate of flow of charge. In other words, the current flowing in a conductor is the amount of charge flowing per second across any cross section of it. It is denoted by the letter I, capital I or small I. If a charge Q flows through a cross-section normal to its direction of motion in time t seconds, then current I through the conductor is given as I is equal to Q by T. Note, current in a circuit is measured by an ammeter by connecting it in series in that circuit, taking care that the positive marked terminal of the ammeter is towards a positive terminal of the source of the current. Now, the unit of current. What is the unit of current? The SI unit of charge is coulomb, and therefore current is measured in coulomb per second, which has been given the name ampere, symbol A, in honor of the French physicist André Ampère. We define 1 ampere as a current which flows in a conductor when 1 coulomb of charge passes through it in 1 second. Therefore, 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb by 1 second. That is equal to 1 C per second. To express a weak current, smaller units of current are used. They are milliampere MA and microampere mu A, which are related to ampere A as follows. 1 milliampere equals 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere, and 1 microampere is equal to 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere. Now let us learn about the flow of current. In metals, the moving charges are the free electrons which constitute the current, which in electrolytes and ionized gases, both the positively charged ions, cations, and the negatively charged ions, anions, are the moving charges which constitute the current. If n electrons pass through a cross section of conductor in time t seconds, then total charge passed through the conductor is given as q equals n into e, and the current in conductor is I is equal to q by t, that is equal to n e by t. Since 1 coulomb charge is carried by 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons, so if 1 ampere current flows through a conductor, it implies that 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons pass in 1 second across a cross section of a conductor. Note that current is a scalar quantity. By stating the direction of current in a conductor, we mean that the direction of motion of electrons is opposite to it. The second point to be noted is, if in an electrolyte, if N1 cations, each of charge Q1, move in one direction, and N2 anions, each of charge Q2, move in an opposite direction in time t, the current in the direction of motion of cations will be I equals N1 Q1 plus N2 Q2 divided by t. Now, the concept of potential and potential difference. Potential, what do you mean by potential? We know that like charges repel while unlike charges attract each other. If a charge A is brought near another like charge B, some work has to be done in moving the charge A against the repulsive force on it due to the other charge B. Similarly, if a charge A is brought near another unlike charge B, work is done by the attractive force on the charge A due to the unlike charge B. Thus, some work is always involved in moving a charge in the vicinity of another charge. Therefore, the potential at a point in a region of charges is measured in terms of the work done in moving a test charge from a point of zero potential to that point, since force between the two charges is zero at infinite separation. Therefore, we consider the potential to be zero when the test charge is at infinite separation from the other charges. The work done in bringing the test charge from infinity to a point in the region of other charges, when divided by the value of the test charge so as to express for unit charge, gives a potential at that point. Thus, we can define the potential as follows. The potential at a point is defined as the amount of work done per unit charge in bringing a positive test charge from infinity to that point. It is denoted by the symbol V. It is a scalar quantity. So, the potential difference at a point, it is defined as the amount of work done per unit charge in bringing a positive test charge from infinity to that point. Note, the potential is positive at a point in the vicinity of a positive charge, since work has to be done on the positive test charge against a repulsive force due to the positive charge in bringing it from infinity, while it is negative at a point in the vicinity of a negative charge, since the attractive force on the positive test charge due to the negative charge does work by itself, or work is obtained. In figure 8.1, a test charge plus Q is brought from infinity to a point P, the vicinity of a positively charged body. So, if W joule of work is done in bringing the test charge Q coulomb from infinity to the point P, then electric potential V at that point P is given as V equals W by Q. Obviously, the work needed to move a charge Q from infinity to a point P where electric potential is V will be W equals QV. Now, unit of electric potential. Unit of potential V is equal to unit of work, that is W, divided by unit of charge Q. The SI unit of work is joule and that of charge is coulomb. So, the SI unit of potential is joule per coulomb or JC to the power of minus 1, which has been given the name volt, symbol V, in honor of the scientist Alessandro Volta. Hence, the potential at a point is said to be 1 volt when 1 joule of work is done in bringing 1 coulomb charge from infinity to that point. Thus, you get 1 volt is equal to 1 joule by 1 coulomb. That is equal to 1 J C to the power of minus 1. Now, potential difference, PD. In practice, when we consider the flow of current between two points, that is A and B of an electric circuit, we consider only the flow of charge between the two points A and B. Therefore, it is not necessary to know the exact potential at each point A and B. It is sufficient to know the potential difference, abbreviated as PD, between the two points A and B. Using the definition of potential at a point, the potential difference between two points can be defined as follows. The potential difference PD between two points is equal to the work done per unit charge in moving a positive test charge from one point to the other. It's an important factor. The potential difference PD between two points is equal to the work done per unit charge in moving a positive test charge from one point to the other. It is a scalar quantity. If W joule of work is done in moving a test charge Q coulomb from a point A to a point B, the potential difference between the two points A and B is VA minus VB. That is equal to W by Q. Note, the potential difference between two points in an electric circuit is measured by a voltmeter which is connected across those points in parallel with the circuit, taking care that the positive marked terminal of the voltmeter is connected to the higher potential point. Now, let's learn about the unit of potential difference. Potential difference, PD, is also expressed in volt. The potential difference between two points is said to be 1 volt if the work done in moving 1 coulomb charge from one point to the other is 1 joule. That is, 1 volt is equal to 1 joule by 1 coulomb. That's equal to 1 J C minus 1. Now, the concept of resistance. When current flows through a conductor, say a metallic wire, the conductor wire offers some obstruction to the flow of current, that is, it offers some resistance to the movement of charges through it. Thus, the obstruction offered to the flow of current by the conductor or wire is called its resistance. Cause of resistance. When a metal is formed, its atoms lose electrons from its outer orbit. A metal or conductor has a large number of wandering electrons and an equal number of fixed positive ions. The positive ions do not move, while the electrons move almost freely inside the metal. These electrons are called free electrons. They move at random, colliding amongst themselves and with the positive ions in any direction as shown below. Can you see here the flow of current in a metal wire? Cell is there. When no potential difference is applied, it is all positive. Positive ions, metal wire, electrons. So, when you connect it with the cell, it's all in the same direction. When potential difference is applied. Here it is when no potential difference is applied. In figure 8.2, the net flow of electrons in any direction is zero, so no current flows. When the ends of the metal wire are connected to a cell or a source of current, that is, when a potential difference is applied across the ends of the metal wire, the electrons inside it experience a force in the direction from the end at negative potential towards the end or at positive potential of the conductor, due to which they begin to move as shown in the figure 8.2b. Due to the force, their speed increases, but during the movement, they collide with the fixed positive ions and lose some of their kinetic energy, due to which their speed decreases. This lost energy heats up the wire. After the collision, they are again accelerated towards a positive potential due to the existing potential difference. So their speed again increases, and then again in collision with the positive ions, their speed decreases. This process continues. As a result, the electrons do not move in bulk with a continuously increasing speed, but there is an overall drift of electrons towards a positive terminal. Thus, a metal wire offers some resistance to the flow of electrons through it. The resistance of a conductor depends on the number of collisions suffered by the electrons with the positive ions while moving from one end to the other end. Ohm's law suggests that V equals IR. If two conductors at different potentials are kept in contact or joined by a metallic wire, the electrons begin to move from a conductor having an excess of electrons to the conductor having a deficit of electrons. Due to the motion of electrons from one conductor to the other, the current flows between them. But this flow continues till both the conductors acquire the same potential. Then the flow of current between them stops. Hence, for a continuous flow of current in a metallic wire, the two conductors at its ends must maintain a definite potential difference. In other words, for a continuous flow of current in a conductor, a constant potential difference has to be maintained across its ends. In 1826, a German scientist, George Simon Ohm, by his experiments, found a relationship between the potential difference and current in a conductor. This relationship is stated in the form of a law known as Ohm's law. Statement of Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, the current flowing in a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across its ends, provided that the physical conditions and the temperature of the conductor remain constant. The direct proportionality between current and potential difference implies that if the potential difference across the ends of a conductor is doubled, the current flowing in it also gets doubled. If a current I flows in a conductor when the potential difference across its ends is V, then according to Ohm's law, I is directly proportional to V, or V by I equals constant. In equation 8.9, we put the constant equal to R, the resistance of the conductor, then V equals IR. The resistance R is a constant at a given temperature for the given conductor. If I is equal to 1, then V is equal to R. Thus, the resistance of a conductor is numerically equal to the potential difference applied across its ends for the flow of unit current through it. Unit of resistance. From relation 8.10, unit of R equals unit of V by unit of I. The SI unit of potential difference is volt, and that of current is ampere. So, the unit of resistance is volt per ampere, or VA to the power of minus 1, which is named after the scientist Ohm as Ohm. It is denoted by the symbol omega. 1 ohm is defined as the resistance of a conductor is said to be 1 ohm if 1 ampere current flows through it when a potential difference of 1 volt is applied across the ends of a conductor. That is, 1 ohm equals 1 volt by 1 ampere. High resistance are measured in the units called kilo ohms and mega ohm, m omega, where 1 kilo ohm or 1 kilo omega equals 10 to the power of 3 omega, and 1 mega ohm or 1 m omega equals 10 to the power of 6 ohms. Conductance. The reciprocal of resistance is called conductance. It is denoted by the letter G. Thus, conductance equals 1 by resistance. Its unit is ohm minus 1, omega minus 1, or Simon, symbol S. Nowadays we do not write MHO for ohm minus 1. So, IV graph. For a metallic conductor, the ratio V by I is constant for all values of V and I. If a graph is plotted for current I against potential difference V, we get a straight line passing through the origin as shown in figure 8.3. I in the vertical line, V in the horizontal line, you get the graph oblique line. So, V graph for a metallic conductor. Slope of IV graph. The slope of IV graph is delta I by delta V, which is the reciprocal of resistance of the conductor. That is, slope equals delta I by delta V. That is equal to 1 by resistance of the conductor. Limitation of Ohm's law. Ohm's law is obeyed only when the temperature of the conductor remains constant. The next class will continue in the next video.
Hit the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get instant updates of the video that we post.